Hello and welcome to a new video. I hope you're having an amazing day. And in this video, we'll be painting watercolor beetroots. So if you are interested in what materials I am using my Winsor & Newton watercolor brushes, my filbert brush in a size 2, and my round brush, which is in the sizes 3 and 5. I use my Montmartre watercolor set and my Canson 300 GSM mixed media sketchbook. And for the initial sketch, I use my Lakeland watercolor soluble pencils. So, first things first, I sketched out an outline of my 4 beetroots I would be painting, and I used my fingers to guesstimate how large they would be on my page, and then I began sketching. Now, with this painting, it is different to my previous fruit and veggies, as I made it more illustrative to accommodate a more simplistic style and to continue practicing my wet on wet technique. This means that in my sketch, I drew in a more whimsical way and how I wanted them to look. So in my reference photo, you can see that they are tied up for the ease of being bought, but I didn't want them to look so stiff. So, I changed the form of the stems to be more curved and flimsy. The bottom of the beetroot that appeared like a tail, I made it more curved and lively than compared to the dry skin from my reference. So with the leaves, as I changed the form and the direction of the stems from the original photo, I had to adjust the angle of the leaves, but still retaining the form of the beetroot leaves. This is an important thing to note when you are changing anything from the original, is that it has to have features from the original in order to be distinguished. Before I started painting, since my paint is less pigmented, it takes longer to mix the paints. So, since I am using a wet on wet technique for the first part, I pre-mixed my colours. It's good to make a list of the colours you are mixing together in case you didn't mix enough paint, and swatch colours you have mixed to make sure you got a more or less colour match. So, for the darkest part of my beetroot, I mixed a dark purple. This dark purple was not in my original photo, but I was hesitant to add brown from my previous paintings, so I looked at other examples of watercolor paintings, and a dark purple seemed to be a popular alternative. As a beginner, it can be really helpful to take inspiration from other watercolor paintings and the solutions other people have come up with, whether it be color combinations, creating tones, color schemes, compositions, painting technique, and so forth. So if in doubt, then get inspiration. So, the colours that I mix for this beetroot painting are: for the leaves, the lightest tone I mix green light with yellow mid, then for the mid tone I added sap green, and the darkest tone I mix sap green, burnt and raw umber, and viridian green, and there may have been a bit of Prussian blue. For the beetroots, the more iconic beetroot colour, I mix magenta with burnt sienna. The dark purple, I mixed violet, magenta, and burnt sienna. On to the actual painting part. So, like with my last video, make sure you have a wet brush. Not dripping wet, but wet enough with enough pigment for a wash to give you a general idea of where your tones will be and making sure to leave space for your highlights. Don't worry too much if this wash has that cauliflower effect like mine from adding too much water, as you will be able to go over this with more pigment and so this won't be seen. With the leaves, I only did one wet on wet layer and then I added wet on dry detail, so this layer was important for me to get right. But this happened first time for me. If you need to correct it, then you can do a second layer of wet on wet. But the leaves are easier to do a wet on wet technique as it is a smaller area of the paint, so the page will stay wet for longer and is quicker to paint. So, I made sure to add my tones with the page while it was still wet and made it darker on the edge of the leaves and all the shadowed underside areas of the leaves. I made sure to add enough pigment to my leaves so they were saturated enough. Then I moved on to the second layer of my beetroots. This is going to be more pigmented than the wash, and this is like a second attempt for me to practice my wet on wet with the mistakes of my wash. So this time, I made sure that the area of my beetroot was wet enough and to stay wet enough when I added the pigments and to allow them to blend. I felt that the less I did, the better, and too many strokes and moving the paint and the water around too much can disturb the flow of the blending process. So starting with two colors when practicing your wet on wet technique can simply make the process less overwhelming. For the beetroot, I added a few more lines to suggest the round form of the beetroot a bit more, and then I added a few more dark tones on the stems and the leaves. So, the wet on wet technique part of this painting is done, and now it is time to add a bit more detail. So, for the leaves, I added the veins of the leaves with the same magenta of the beetroot, and then I added more mid and darkest tones of the leaves so that they are a little more three-dimensional, but not overdoing it since I aim to make this painting as simple to my liking. When adding the shadows of the leaves and to avoid harsh edges, you can dampen your brush and soften up the edges of the wet on dry strokes. This means it is more controlled but still soft-like with a wet on wet technique. And then we are done. Thank you so much for watching. If you like these types of videos, learning and painting with me, then don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe for weekly videos. God bless, and I'll see you later.